so for you, I'll briefly introduce the audience as to why we're doing what we're doing now. So, as you know, Major Jacob has had a series of interviews wherein he has spoken about his life in the armed forces thus far. But there's a journey, it's a journey which has come ahead. So, going forward, today he will be talking about his current project, that is Operation Blue Freedom, and his team, that is Claw Global, right? So, how was your response to the immense love that came out of the interviews that you gave in the past month or so?
See, love always feels good. Love always feels good. It's we are human beings, and love is the ultimate reason for anything to exist. So when you feel love, it feels good, and it's, I feel the love, same love back. So good.
So why do you think that people resonated with it so much? In the sense that people are writing in from across the globe. There are young people who say that they listen to it on loop. And then there are people who are saying that, you know, I listen to it when I feel stressed out. There are people whose lives have been touched so deeply. You know, why do you think it resonated on such a level?
I think it resonated because everybody is a human being, and this is about humanity. So, kya bolte hain? You know, we live in a certain set of insecurities in our life. We are, you know, roti, kapda, makan, or izzat. So, in cheezon ke liye, you know, these things are linked to something outside. All of these things are equated as happiness, and happiness is something that has been taught to us that it's outside. So, we are all constantly seeing something outside and running after it, and we feel insecure because we never feel satisfied with what we already have inside and what we already have. Yeah. So if you got your two hands and legs or whatever, if you got your brain ticking, your eyes are open and you're conscious, you got everything that you need. So that is what I'm like doing, mm-hmm. what I'm saying, or I'm trying to showcase through Operation Blue Freedom. That, you know, if you are looking at freedom and you are seeking freedom, and that is what ultimately human beings as a species, that's what we are looking for. We're looking to be free. That's our reason. That's the point from where you actually start living. Once you become free, then you can actually live. So how do you get that freedom? You know, in the internal world, you meditate. You go into a deep meditation and you will reach freedom, right? But I feel that that's a great thing, you know, meditation and reaching there, and it's a beautiful, beautiful thing, and I try to do it. But I also feel that there's a reason why we are alive. We are born, we have this human body, and with this body we have muscles, we have a brain, it can calculate stuff, you know, and we feel emotions, right? So all these things are the things that make us human, and it's great to be human, yeah. And God cannot do what we can do, right? God can't do what we can do. God can do everything, you know, and everything is like nothing, you know. So human beings, when they feel and they create and they live their lives out based on how they feel, and being human, being emotional, being, you know, making the choices, you know, facing consequences, sometimes the good, sometimes the bad, and that's what makes life. So, you know.
So, that's one thing that, you know, people have been asking you, you should speak more, and then you should share your ideas more and more. But somewhere you chose this path where you wanted to live it out and show it to the world by doing it. You know, that's one of the reasons. Your transition from special forces to what you're doing now. So, what made you choose this approach that I would rather live it out and show it?
Because, see, Madhav, it's, I'm here to do something, right? And it has to be done in a certain way. And in the way that I understand. And of course, I want people to see this and people to, you know, do their thing and feel as good as I feel doing what I'm doing, right? Everybody should feel good. So there's logically there is no reason to feel bad about anything in life, you know. But that comes from a certain understanding or a certain acceptance, certain level of self-realization, whatever. So to answer your question specifically, I am doing this for myself because I want to do it, right? And for the sake of efficiency, if I start doing things other than what I should be doing, I'll not be able to do what I do. So if I've got something to show and something to share, and it is like in the path of the direction that I have chosen and I have taken, then I'll do it. So, you know, walk with us. The closer you come to us, the more you'll see. So, and of course, I will share what needs to be shared.
So, in your previous interviews, people have heard about your the origin of Operation Blue Freedom. You know, it started with you meeting that Air Force officer and it triggering a certain thought pattern in you. And then you setting on this, and one thing led to the other, and it was the universe unfolding in front of you. But this Operation Blue Freedom has been a journey for you. So if you could just go over the journey, your experiences on this journey of Operation Blue Freedom. It's been close to 2 years now. And if you look at the origin per se, it's more than 3, 4, 5 years. 2015 is when you met the Air Force officer and it got you thinking. So if you take from that, it's almost a journey of 5 years. So if you take it from the day you quit the army, even then it is 3 years since then. In 2017 you quit the army. In 2015, you met that Air Force officer. So, this transition, if you could go over it.
So, Operation Blue Freedom, it's a phenomena. It's an occurrence, right? In this universe where time is moving from, you know, left to right or whatever, it has a supposed beginning and, you know, supposed end. So, so I was born somewhere in between there, right? And the universe created me, right? So it brought me to life and put me through a certain set of experiences, gave me a certain set of parents who had their own experiences, which I, you know, soaked in from them, their character, their personality, their adherence to truth, right? So all of that I picked up from there, a certain freedom. My father was a very, very free man, very, very free. I mean, not because he's my father or anything, but he's one of the most freest human beings I've met in my life. He was not afraid of death also. He could not rationalize what it is, but in his heart it did not scare him. Right? He's one man I have seen like who didn't care. He didn't care. And he loved immensely. He loved people immensely, he loved life immensely. So I saw that, right? And I also saw him, you know, I also saw him turn from the white what he was to a certain darkness, you know, from light to darkness. I saw that transition also, where, you know, and I learned from his how, I will not call it a mistake, I'll say he was what he was, and he accepted his mistakes as much as his good, as much as his bad, you know, he accepted both equally. So that was, I was born in those certain set of circumstances as a family. I was born with a certain body which could perform certain things, right? And I had strength or whatever, so like that. And then I used to do a lot of physical exercises with my father. Bachpan se hi hum bhag rahe hain, theek hai. And from there, going to boarding school, some experiences there. And then, you know, like my parents broke up, and the experiences that I saw after that, right? Experiences I saw in when you have money, what it means, what life feels like, and when you don't have money, what life feels like, right? I experienced that. And kya kehte hain, then I came to Delhi, and after boarding school I saw whatever I experienced there, and then I joined NDA for whatever reasons. I was there and I experienced 3.5 years there, and then IMA, something there. Then I joined the Special Forces for whatever reason, but I experienced something there. So it was, and then I landed up in that hospital. So life brought me there, right? That's what life showed me. Sometimes it was destiny, sometimes you feel you're making a choice or whatever, right? But it was there. And then I was there and I met this guy, and whatever those, you know, 34, 35 years, whatever age I was at that time, and I was the kind of person who would look at something and if my heart would connect, I would want to fucking help. And if I want to help something, I will make it happen. So I had become like that. And through my experiences in life and especially in the special forces, I realized that we all, you know, we have ability. Every human being has ability, and his responsibility is to exercise that bloody ability, right? So I'm just exercising my ability. I believe this should be done. It's a good thing for the world, and let's do it. Yeah.
So this thing of, you know, your lived experiences accumulating and dictating, you know, in some way influencing how you think, and that's also because all along you have taken lessons, you collected lessons, because this is something working with you. I've seen you calculate possibilities and calculate the risk matrix and forecast very, very precisely, you know, what works, what doesn't work. You know, it's easy for us to have life experiences and miss the lessons out of it. So this accumulated lessons which you put in into Operation Blue Freedom, you know, starting
70th August 1979 onwards.
Yeah. So 2017 you quit the army. Now 2018 the team starts gathering around you, people, you know, people who you work with, like Main Bahadur and other people from the Navy and
yourself.
So on. Yeah, I mean, you start collecting around it and then you start putting things to action. And formally it was launched, though it was formally launched in 2019, but there's a lot of things in life experiences which brought you there. But let's say we put it at that, when Operation Blue Freedom, I believe, was conceptualized in this very place, the house.
Yes, here, right here on this table. On this table.
Yeah, yeah. So a little bit about...
Yes. Little bit about?
Little bit about how you, you know, the initial days, when you conceptualized it, when the team was getting together around you, and, you know, how you started this journey, people you met, what conviction you were moving, you know, in the world. It was a new paradigm of thought process. So what was the resistance you faced? And
so it's not an, I don't know if it would be a new paradigm of thought process. A lot of people in history have thought of freedom and discussed what it means to be free. A lot of philosophers are there or whatever. And even in contemporary, you know, all of us are seeking that, and we all have our own ideas about what it means to be free. So it's just we go through experiences that make us realize that, help us realize what we are, right, or what we can do. So SF, when I was in the SF and I was seeing the men that I was walking with and the experiences that I was going through, and I was watching myself also, you know, you always, it's, you know, we live in an environment which always tells us more or less, you know, that you are less than what you actually are. And it's like a big thing, like you, your own consciousness is limited to such a level that you feel that, yaar, main to yehi kar sakta hun ya wahi kar sakta hun, ye nahi hoga to main kya karunga, right? That's where we are generally operating, and that is possibly because of the way the environment that we have grown up in, right? And then kya kehte hain, you go through certain experiences in life and those experiences show you what you are, right? So it's like this, you know, if you talk about fear of death, fear of consequences, fear of whatever, right? So when you actually see death, when you see it, so you realize you're not afraid. It doesn't matter. It's a very intense moment, and you are completely like, you suddenly realize that everything is, it's just, no, it is, that's it. This is just also another is, and you're just very, very, there are no thoughts. There are no thoughts, they are just, there's a realization, that's all, you know. So when you see that also, and then everything else, you know, you realize that, yeah, you know, if you can't do something, let's do it, yeah. What's the point of being alive otherwise?
this thought about, you know, at every stage in the past also people seeking freedom in their own way. So you consider it not as a new paradigm, but even if it's not a new paradigm, it's still in every epoch or in
that
every
perception may be something. So okay, freedom, right? Freedom from what? Freedom from everything. And what is that? That is as per our, like, Buddhism or whatever, you know, whatever my understanding of Buddhism is, or of what meditation is, and what moksha means, moksha, freedom, right? What it means to be free is complete, you know, this complete detachment from everything, to realize what it actually is, right? So that is one way. Yes, I understand that, and I feel that, okay, that's one way. Yes, right, and it makes very complete logical sense. But then we are alive as well. We are alive as well, right? You are there, you know, I'm there, and we share something so fucking beautiful, and we are doing something so fucking beautiful. I mean, if I had a chance to detach from all of this, would I? I wouldn't. I would experience this. I would want this experience. Right, so that is also a way to freedom, you know. I don't know, they say karma yoga or whatever, so this is like that, you know, meditation or freedom or moksha through action, right? So this is what I feel, so since, you know, that's the choice you make.
So talking of that, one thing is that, you know, you're seeking freedom on your own accord, that you wanted to do it collectively, that you wanted to do it together as a team. You wanted to gather your former special forces colleagues and put together a team. And even in the broader vision of it, you are talking about, you know, showing the way to freedom for everyone, demonstrating it.
Yeah.
See, this is a way to freedom.
Yes.
It's for everyone.
The demonstration is by chance as well, it's incidental, and it is by design as well, both. So kya kehte hain, yeah, sorry, continue.
Yeah, that's it. That you know, that how you decided that it's for everyone or for no one, you know, that line that you use, that freedom is a collective experience, either all of us have or none of us do. You can elaborate.
So it that line is exactly what it is, and it does not mean anything other than what it means, right? And what it means is freedom is a collective experience. Either all of us have it or none of us really do, right? You think you are free, but, you know, if you analyze it, you realize you're not, right? So I realized ki what does it mean for me to be free? For me to be free, everyone in this world has to be free. Otherwise, there will be some, you know, if it's like a spider's net, right? And one fucking, you know, spider ka web ka one small, you know, strand. If it vibrates, the vibration will be felt across the web, right? So if someone is unhappy or unfree in this world, it is affecting my freedom in some way or the bloody other. So that is one, you know, perspective that I saw and made sense to me. And the other thing was that I just, kya yaar, life mein hai kya? Kitna paisa kamaoge? What is it? Kitna kha loge? Actually, aadmi ko jinda rehne ke liye kitna chahiye yaar? In a mountain, if I'm naked, I'll survive. You know, I'll find something, I'll do something, I'll protect myself. You know, I'll protect the life that I have, and I will do something, right? So all that is there to do in this life is to make the world a better place. It's your children who are going to, you know, it's you, it's life which is going to experience comfort or discomfort, freedom or you know, bondage. You know, freedom or chaos. You know? So it is who will do it. So at some point in life, I used to feel, yaar, ki yaar, you know, koi aur karega. And then I realized, ki brother, your freedom is your own responsibility. So you do what you need to do for your freedom. That's what I felt, and then that's one of the reasons as well. Where the people get involved, so Operation Blue Freedom, it's when I first thought of it, I just thought of it. It just came to my mind. Three world records, land, sea and air, buddy, all the three elements, right? So I just thought of it, and I just, it was like all the problems that I could see were all sorted by this. So it was an impossible thing to dream of by human standards, if one might say, you know. It was, I mean, it's impractical, illogical, never done before, never thought of before. There, I mean, completely no reasons for me to do it, except that I feel like doing it. So if I feel like doing it, that is the reason why I will do anything. And this is what I feel like doing. And when I felt like doing this, I want everyone to enjoy it. Yeah, everyone should enjoy it. I can give something to someone. When you give something to someone, right, you feel good. Yeah. So at the end of the day, you're doing it for yourself. Then you feel good. When you can share, I'm not talking about money, right? I'm talking about, you know, just supporting in some, you know, walking together. Yeah, it's a journey. We are walking, you know. At the end of the day, we are all same. So, if, like I said, you know, for me to feel good, the best thing, I would feel the best if I could give something to the world, to everyone. So that.
So a lot of, there are people who see a disconnect between what you were doing and earlier in Special Forces and now. But deep down, you know there is a continuity in the sense, that, so you in many ways epitomize what it is to be a Special Forces soldier. So you always crave to experience it in the highest form, right? So you sought truth through what you were doing in the Special Forces. You were trying to stick as close as possible to realize what it means to be a Special Forces soldier. Now coming outside, so people see this as, some people see it as a disjunct, you know, there's a break in what you're doing, but deep down, I know it. So if you could, for the audience, tell what is the continuity between the Special Forces mindset, which you tried, you epitomize and which you sought very closely while in forces, and now?
So, Special Forces was all there, if you look at life, not just life. Life, please, is all as per my understanding and my perception based on my experiences, right? There is not true or false. It is what I think and I feel. So life is, you know, happens between you know, birth and death, right? These are two opposite sides of life, right? And then black and white, right? Good and evil. Right, so happiness and sadness, so there, life happens between these two boundaries, the spectrum in between, you know, shades of these, you know, two sides, you know, two sides of one thing is where life is happening in between. So pardon me, I just lost my track there a little bit. So it's happening between these two things, right? And Special Forces was all about destruction. It was all about destroying. As far as I was concerned, and of what I knew of myself, and I knew of the men with me, right? That team, you know, we could destroy anything. There was nothing that we cannot destroy, right? And it was as if that there is nothing beyond this in destruction. So I just, at some point, I disassociated from destruction and I analyzed it. I'm fucking good at what I do, and I'm right now good at destroying stuff, right? So if I shifted this vision, this outlook, this way of living life to the other extreme, to creation, right? So let's see how we feel here. And I started realizing that, yeah, this is much more than destruction. And special forces, where is the connect, right? So that's the background, right? From destruction to creation. That's energy being focused in one direction, picked up, focused in another direction. Choice was mine. Choice based on a simple logic, calculated logic, that life is about experiences. So I have to experience everything. This, seen there, been there, done that. Right? And like it was to a level where I was at such a level consciously in destruction that, you know, it's like I had carved out on my weapon, you know, left hand of God. Right? And this is why I mean this, left hand of God. So right hand of God is to bless, right? And left hand of God is to fucking, you know, chop it off. Right? So I used to believe that, you know, we are the left hand of God. Right? So been there, yeah. And then I just experienced this. I had this experience. I got disassociated from this. And I was in a flow. I didn't know what I want. I was searching for something. I was looking back into my past and seeing what are the things that I enjoyed doing. I wanted to enjoy my life, right? Feel good, bliss, right? Through meditation, I started understanding what it feels just to have a glimpse of what bliss means. So I wanted to experience that, and I wanted to experience life. So I shifted that energy, and I was waiting what to do with it. And I was letting life happen. I learned to relax. I was in hospital, so you know the routine was very easy there. And I read a lot of things. I saw a lot of things on the internet and expanded my level of knowledge. I was very curious. I explored in a certain direction. And I met this Air Force officer, and he posed a problem to me. Jacob sir, मुझे ये करना है, मैं कैसे करूँगा? आप तो इसमें तो आप expert होंगे. तो I said, यार ऐसा तो कुछ, you know, in my mind, if a problem is presented to me, somewhere, somehow, in my experiences, I've learned that if there's a problem, it can be solved. Finished. That's the starting point, right? So when you know it can be solved, so you start thinking like that, right? So I met this guy, problem solved, and I felt love. I felt an empathy. I felt, you know, like I could be like that anytime, you know. I could lose my legs. I've lived in a fucking profession where I could have died so many fucking times, right? And like, you know, we travel in cars and high speed sometimes, and this, that, trains, planes, all of that, you know, sometimes the fucking building falls, you know, you can die anytime, you can get maimed anytime, this can happen to anybody anytime, right? So, I mean, like, yeah, I just felt, and Fauji bhi tha, you know, so that kind of connection was also there, and I just felt as a human being, as a layer, you know, I can do that, yeah. And it's just a human being who asked me something, yeah, sir, can you? So, yes, sir, you know, let me find out. So I went and found out, and I saw that somebody had done something like that earlier.
Yeah.
So not only is it possible, it's been done before.
Yeah.
So I showed it to him, and then I started planning it. So the problem immediately which came up, you know, there were certain problems that immediately started coming up. So I retired back into myself, and I started making a solution. And in that solution, I realized, in the plan that I was making, I realized that to help people with, or I'll not say help, to walk with people with disabilities, right, I would need to generate value for able-bodied people as well. So if I'm able to give value to able-bodied people, then I can generate so much of resources that I can channelize all of that towards this sizable, you know, chunk of human life. So that connects directly up with, you know, freedom is a collective experience. Either all of us have it or none of us really do. And, you know, disabilities itself as a subject, if you just look at it, what is it? There is a supposed certain standard of what it is means to be a perfect human being. Right? Psychologically, you're supposed to be in a certain way, you know, and physically, you're supposed to be in a certain way, and that is called, a human being who is like totally fit. But actually, if you see the world and you see each and every human being in this world, each and every human being is flawed. As for this perfection, each and every human being is flawed. only God is not Lord, right? So I mean, we, so somewhere this is a bondage of perception, right? So we have to be free from that bondage of perception. And everybody has issues, man. Everybody, you put me one person in front of me that who doesn't have an issue, like I'll break him down and show him his issues, right? So you show me one man like that, you know, I don't think anybody like that exists. It's God, yeah. God is flawless. So let us, you know, it's something. And how does it translate? Like we say, people with disabilities, they need this, they need that, you know, this, that, whatever. You just think one thing. It is, let's, if you just take a common thing, right? What is, from that supposed standard of what it means to be a perfect human being psychologically, there is a spectrum of which supposedly goes down like that. And then, you know, people who are considered that they don't have a healthy mental faculty, yeah. Right? So that is where the disability things, you know, they say ki yaha hai. And then there's the same thing physically as well, right? There is the same thing physically as well. And just a second now. So, you know, you're supposed to be virile, young, and this, that, and you know, there you are. And then there's somebody who doesn't have arms and legs, right? So, or doesn't have an A arm or A leg, or doesn't have arms and legs altogether. So, there's somebody like that. But just think of this. All of us are young and all of us grow old as well, right? All of us grow old as well. So we'll all grow old, yeah. And when we grow old, we will, you know, lose our mental faculties. 40 years from now, you wouldn't be thinking at this level. You could, but the way things are right now, you wouldn't be, right? Physically, the same thing. You know, 40 years from now, you know, if you can get out of your bed and take a shit on your own, good luck, buddy, right? So that's, you know, so everybody's going to go through this, man, at some point or the bloody other. So if we can take a human body and, you know, like bloody, you know, make it like a cyborg, you know, it will, and at that level of assistive technology we bring in, so all of us in our old age will be like still, you know, going for walks and going to the bloody loo on our own, drinking our own water, right, making our own food, going to the, you know, riding horses, yeah. So that's the thing. It's stake for everyone, including myself.
Yeah.
Which is most important.
True. So there's this concept of disabilities and ever expanding concept, which also includes.
Can I have a cigarette?
Yeah.
I'll take a short break. Huh?
We can take a short break.
No, we'll finish this off.
Thanks.
I'll just pass me my tobacco. We can continue.
Uh-huh.
No. Yeah. On.
So that is one thing. So there are several of these learnings that you, by virtue of your background, as you mentioned earlier, that there are several learnings that you bring forward into what you're doing currently. So in your conceptualization of the triple world record, so you often say that, you know, imagine something that is very, very extreme that will make you evolve, right? So this something has got some kind of an overlap with the probation, you know, that you put that probationer to an extreme level, you know,
yeah.
It makes him evolve. Either he evolves or he breaks.
Yeah.
So you move by setting yourselves, you know, the extreme goals, and then in the process evolving. So if we could go over this methodology, why you conceptualize the triple world record, and the how the enormity of it has made so many things easy for you, or fall in place for you, or make yourselves evolve, and how it relates to your experiences in America, even, you know, probation, be it the kind of ops that you've sought, you know, every time you've reached a level, you've sought the next extreme level, the next extreme level. So it's like that. I see it as a continuum, you know, from.
It's logical thing to do.
Yeah, so.
It's a logical thing to do. Wouldn't you do that?
Yeah.
So,
no,
Achha, okay.
If you can go over how setting enormous goals helps you evolve.
see, it's like this, ki, you don't know what you can do,
yeah.
Right? Only God knows what he is, right? All those people who are alive, and I don't know about people who have gone to like Himalayas and sat down there and meditated and, you know, detached from the world. I don't know about them. Maybe they know what they can do, maybe they don't know what they can do. But you don't just go climb the mountain and become a Buddha. It takes years. People have, supposedly mythology, people have meditated for 200 years, 1000 years, right? So, you know, that is also a process. You're experiencing. So through deep meditation, you're experiencing more. There's more light being shed on what is the truth, right? And like, that's one way. But in life, if you choose to live life like karma yoga, right, something like that, to live life through action, right? So if you just set the bar here, you will only experience this much. And if you don't shift the bar after experiencing this much, you won't evolve, you won't experience, you will keep experiencing the same damn thing over and over and over and over again. You might as well be dead, right? So what you do is you set the bar higher. So depending on your level of confidence and your level of self-realization, you will see what is achievable and what is not, which is fine. You don't have to do fantastic things to feel good. You know, it's about learning how much you can do. So you, in the learning process, you start carefully, right? You feel your way through. It's like if we have got terrorists inside, you know, in the mountain somewhere, and we have to reach there, you don't just, you know, just walk up there and start knocking them off. What you do is, you know, you plan, you see, you calculate, threat perception, you know, you study the terrain. Where can there be, you know, where can I land up in trouble? What is the ground that I will use so that these buggers don't come to know I'm coming, right? So I do that much that I see I can do, but that much I will do, right? So over a period of time, you start realizing your capacity of doing something is expanding, you're evolving, right? So the special forces mindset is specifically this, that you realize that you can, you know, you can do it, yeah, just do it. And like I said, so there is, you know, if there is something which is of value, it is good for mankind, it will be supported by the universe. The universe supports life, right? So the universe supports life, and like, that's a default mechanism. That's why we are there. So the universe supports life, and if there is any action that a human being is taking that will support life, that action will be supported. Life itself, the universe itself will make it happen. So basically, you can do anything which is good, you know, which you feel good about. And that's your, you know, your radar,
yeah,
as to your feelings. How does this feel? What I'm doing, how is it feeling, right? And I'm doing this feels nice. I should explore this more, right?
So one of the things that you mentioned, you know, setting enormous goals which help you evolve. So another thing that you repeatedly insist is, you know, being true to yourself. I mean, looking inwards and finding out who you are, and finding out what resonates with you as a person, and sticking as close as possible to that. You know, how is that? What is that? You know, how looking inside, being yourself, and how is that useful in achieving things fast, very fast, very efficient when you are yourself. So something that you mentioned repeatedly, say, you know, how has it helped? What is it actually? You know, looking inwards and being yourself and expressing yourself fully.
So I haven't figured out everything yet, right? So, but yeah, I have a certain perspective right now, and that is, you know, what I'll share. So everything is interlinked, right? So if there's an internal world, there is an external world as well. We experience both things. It is where you shift your attention is you will experience that, right? So if you experience yourself on things that make you feel good, you will experience that more, right? So like that, it's a chain. It's like, say, you know, the butterfly effect, that the flappings of the wings of a butterfly in one end of the world can cause a tsunami on the other end of the world, right? So if that is so, and the more clarity you have about what it means to be human, what it means to be right now, right here, the more clarity that you have of that, of your being, you are being right now. You're not being in the past, and you're not being, you don't, the past is gone. We don't even know what it is. It's just a fucking memory in your head. And depending on your impressions, that memory may or may not be accurate. There are various degrees of accuracy of memory, right? So, and you were there, but you're not there anymore. You're not in the past, and you are not in the future as well, because it just hasn't happened yet, right? So where are you right now? You are here right now, and right now, right here, what is there in front of you? There is you, and there is experiences to be had. You're alive. So now you can shift that focus inside, and you can look inside and experience yourself inside, and you can look outside and experience yourself outside. So, and both these things, we are in this reality, and we have chosen to be here, and chosen to be alive, and chosen to act and do things, be human. I'll be God after I'm done being human, yeah, right? No, that thing. So so when you just decide the simple thing of let's see what is there and what can I do with it, right? And you think in a certain manner, in a very precise, precisional manner. That's something that I learned from the SF. That is something that I probably did not have as a child. How to think, right? So in the SF, firstly, they teach you what you can do. They take you to the limits. Pehla kaam hi hota hai ki probation mein wahan pahuncha do bande ko as safely as possible. Take him to his point of failure. Take him to the point where he breaks. Everyone can break. There is no man who is ever born, special forces or who the hell ever. There is no man who cannot be broken, right? Unless he is sitting on some mountain meditating for the last 200 years, right? So you take them there and they see it and they realize, and you take them beyond that, right? You take them beyond that, you go beyond that, and you see, Kinare, I'm still alive, I can still do, there is still some more left in me. And then you build your body and your, you know, reflexes and your handling of your equipment and all of that to, you know, like godlike level, right? So you become better and better and better, and you become stronger and stronger, and your mind also becomes more and more free, and you start believing. And then from when you're showed that, then you're taken into operations, right? So when you go into ops with that mindset, with that physical strength, with that, all of that, when you go into operations and there, and you are like, what the hell is going on? What is my job? My job is to finish off terrorists in this area, right? Or do this, what my country has asked me to do, what my president entrusted with me with, right? I've come here to do that. So if I come here to do that, what is, I will wipe out that problem, yeah, right? So you approach the whole thing from that mindset. जड़ से खत्म कर देंगे, राइट? एंड सो एंड देन देर इज अ प्रोसेस टू एक्सपीरियंस दैट, टू अचीव दैट, राइट? सो इन दैट प्रोसेस यू लर्न टू क्लासिफाई डेटा. यू फर्स्ट लर्न टू क्लासिफाई डेटा एज व्हाट इज रेलेवेंट एंड इज सेमी रेलेवेंट एंड इररेलेवेंट, राइट? यू क्लासिफाई दैट डेटा एंड देन यू स्टार्ट क्रंचिंग दैट डेटा डाउन. यू पुट दैट डेटा इनसाइड यू, right? So for example, you know, in the mountains, like I used to spend about every day, so I never used to go out. Anyway, let's not talk about hops. So very simply this, that, you know, there's a lot of homework which goes into doing something like this, but you know, it's not hard work. I've like never worked hard in my life. Just expressing yourself, that's all. So there's no need, point being this, is no need to struggle in life about anything. It's like that, na pani mein chhatpataoge to doob jaoge. Pani mein you have to learn to float. If you don't know how to swim, you have to learn to float. And you know, look ki first survive, then stabilize, and then thrive, you know. So life mein, what happens in life is that sometimes you know what you're doing. So you know which way to go, you know which way to swim, you know where you want to reach, and you know how to get there, and you have the skills to get there. Sometimes in life it just lines up like that, right? Sometimes in life, you don't know what the fuck to do. You don't know how to do it. You don't know what to do. So how will you know how to do it? You know, how will you know which direction to take? How will you know whether you have the ability to do or not do? Because you don't know what to do. When you are faced, that's one of the biggest problems I think that we face. It's one of the biggest problems I faced. There was a point in time in my life where I didn't know what to do. So I used to be, you know, I used to be sitting and I used to be shaking. Yaar, main kya karun, yaar, kya karun? Life, it's not making sense. So I learned to relax. I learned to accept nonsense. Everything doesn't need to make sense, yeah. Right? So if it's not making sense, relax. So it's like a river, right? Life is like a river. So you're in that river, you've learned to float, you learn to stabilize, you're chilling, right? And you're flowing in that river. And you are looking on both sides, like you're on your back and you're flowing in that river and you're going downstream. And you're looking at the sides of the river. You're seeing, अच्छा यहाँ पे coconut trees हैं, यहाँ पे अच्छा इधर terrain change हो रहा है, यहाँ पे hills आ रहे हैं, यहाँ पे elephants हैं, यहाँ tigers हैं, or whatever. You know, you're seeing what options are there. What are these things? Do I want to be in that environment? No. This seems interesting, but no. Whatever. So you're going through life, and suddenly and you're on your back and you're going through life and you're chilling and watching things. You know, just looking at things as they are and just let it happen. You'll suddenly see something like beautiful. Wow. And if it's a wow, you'll turn on your this thing and you'll start swimming towards it. Right? You'll start swimming towards it. You'll understand what is the current of the river, and accordingly you will choose your angle, you know, using the river speed and momentum to propel you towards where you want to go. So that's how I live.
Since you mentioned that mindset, special forces mindset of survive, stabilize and then thrive. You put in a hostile condition, you first survive, then you stabilize, you look around, then you thrive. This calm delay and destroy whatever target it was.
Yeah.
So somewhere when you had a spirit to spirit connection with people with disabilities, you saw an overlap of this mindset. You could explain that and
Yeah, of course. This might sound a little harsh. Right, but in the sense, there's no judgment or opinions around this. It's a very logical, cold, calculated thing. Right, heart comes in later.
Yeah.
You know, heart has decided where to go. Now I'm using my brain on how to get there. So, over this, you know, whatever journey of these couple of years, and me and the team, you know, we interacted with a lot of people with spinal cord injuries. You know, we interacted with a lot of people with spinal cord injuries, and I've lived with them, shared a house with them, shared a home with them, right? And I used to just wonder that, you know, like Arman's bathroom, right?
Yeah.
So there's a piece of like a cement block there, you know, inside the loo which is sharp. And he's on a wheelchair and he has to get inside and he has to take a bath, and then this thing is there, and if he slips and he falls, he might pretty hit his head there. And forget about him, I might slip and fall and hit my head there. Right? So I saw that, and then I was, and this is Arman Ali, right? Arman Ali is the executive director of NCPDP. It's a big organization which is empowering people with disabilities, right? And he's the executive director of that, a very powerful man. He writes to the Prime Minister, he addresses, you know, he's engaged with the United Nations, he's a top awarded gentleman, very, very capable man himself. You know, forget about his physical thing, his ability as his personality and his intellectual ability, his emotional quotient, his IQ, everything is very, very high. He's not a average person, and he has a lot of self-confidence as well, that to do what he can perceive, he can act on it, right? And one day I was with him, and one of those days when I was staying with him, and I went to have coffee with him in Cafe Coffee Day, you know, in Connaught Place. And we were sitting there and having our coffee, and he wanted to go to the loo, right? Now the loo was on the first floor, and he did what he could do, and he spoke to the, you know, people there, and they were polite, and they said that, you know, we'll do something about it, but and then he called his driver, and his driver wheeled him away on his wheelchair and took him to his car, and he sat inside his car and he peed inside a bottle, right? Because he cannot access that, you know, the public loo. I mean, if he goes inside that public loo, he might die of some other disease. राइट देन आई थॉट यार कि अगर ये हालत एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर ऑफ एनसीपीडीपी की है तो बाकियों की क्या हालत होगी यार राइट एंड देन देयर मस्ट बी वुमेन देयर मस्ट बी लेडीज राइट एंड सम लेडीज यू नो मेनी लेडीज इन आवर कंट्री दे वेयर सारी दैट इज व्हाट दे वेयर सो लाइक इमेजिन ट्राइंग टू गो इन टू अ पब्लिक लू ऑन अ व्हील चेयर इन अ सारी लाइक इट्स no shouldn't be done you know so I realized all of that I saw experienced it and I saw one thing that ye sare haste rehte hain all the time you know most of like Arman and all he's such a jovial person he's always so his sense of humor is so amazing and this was the case with like you know almost 100% of the people that we met a lot of people with disabilities lots And we not only did we meet them, we worked with them, we stayed with them, we dived with them, we ate with them, saw everything, right? And I was just thinking, man, ki in spite of facing
hostile
environment every day, day in, day out, you know, all his waking moments, you know, they have challenges and they're constantly taking on those challenges with a smile on their face. But that's what it is to be human and that what it means to make a choice and they made a choice that despite of all of this I will still live my life right so that's the ability to make a choice that's strength and to have that perception and then actually live your life and carve your way out in this you know world in this harsh world Right, so that is the spirit, yeah, and that spirit connected. Kehte na special forces mein, there are these qualities which are listed. That 17 qualities that a person must have, then he can become a special forces soldier. Right, so saara ye wo chal raha tha, and I was thinking, which is the most important quality in all of these qualities? Ki yaar aur kuch hona ho, ye 17 cheez to ek insaan mein ho hi nahi sakte. Right, there are various degrees of perfection. सो आई थॉट कि सारे जो है ये क्वालिटीज में सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट क्वालिटी कौन सी होगी एंड दैट इज एन एक्सपीरियंस आई वाज अ टीम कमांडर राइट सो आई थॉट द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज अ ब्लडी सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर यार हम मरने जा रहे हैं और अगर बंदा मेरे बगल में हंस रहा है ना तो बड़ी दैट इज व्हाट आई वांट टू एक्सपीरियंस बिफोर आई डाई राइट मतलब गोलियां चल रही है और बैठ के जोक मार रहा है एंड ऑल अराउंड मी आई वॉज सराउंडेड बाई पीपल लाइक दैट And I was surrounded like people like that even now. All of us are very, very happy people. It's not that we have our joys and sorrows, we have our ups and downs, but internally we always, you know, we always feel that life is good, life is beautiful. Yaar. It has to be lived, we enjoy our life, we enjoy companionship, we live a lot in the moment, right? So that thing, yeah, and everybody can be like that and everybody should be like that.
Somewhere, you know. You internally being like that, you resonate and you attract people like that. Yeah. So that's why you are surrounded by people who are like you.
Yeah.
So it's like that.
I'm surrounded by people who can suffer me.
We all have choices. All of us have choices.
True that.
Yeah. So triple world record per se. Yeah. You know, so this surviving in a hostile environment and that personifying power. A certain powerful spirit and that is what you're trying to project basically show to the world what people with disabilities truly are they're largely misunderstood you know capture what they are truly are and mainstream what they truly are that spirit and that sense of power which is inside them which you as a special forces soldiers because you also shared that kind of a mindset which you could spot it you know how is that What you're doing now, how Operation Blue Freedom connects. In some way, I see a connect between the why of the Triple World Record and the why of Operation Blue Freedom merging.
I didn't get your question.
Yeah, in the sense that how are you capturing the spirit and how are you showing it to the world?
The Triple World Records.
Yeah.
Land, sea and air, people with disabilities from across the world coming together across race, culture, class, religion, economic status, coming together former special forces, you know, special forces veterans from across the world, you know, we are coming together, and you know, the spirit, the same spirit, is taking hand together and sharing stuff between each other, right? It's not we are giving something, aisa kuch nahi hai. We are sharing. I gain a lot from interaction with Arman or whoever. I gain so much, right? So whenever I, you know, whenever I feel a little underconfident about myself, or I feel, you know, am I doing the right thing or something like that, when I need some reason and logic, it's not easy to do what I'm doing. In a way, it's very easy, but you know, then there are struggles, right? There are struggles in the mind, obstacles in the mind. I'm just like everybody else. So we share each other and we support each other, we give each other a hand up, and we are achieving the impossible, yeah. Right? And so that's that, yeah.
Well, just for the
and we are doing it in all the three elements.
Yeah.
Hawa, pani aur zameen pe hum teen world record create kar rahe hain jo aaj tak shayad kisi ne socha bhi nahi hoga.
Yeah.
Right? So it's just something, it's proving a point. And it's not only about proving a point. Proving a point is yes, proving a point, freedom, right? But we are actually getting things done, yeah, on the ground. We have shared an experience of scuba diving with more than 100 people with spinal cord injuries who were paralyzed. Without any money. Without any money we have done it. Right? Whatever little we had, वो तो हमने बहुत पहले फूंक दिया था. पर आज यहाँ बैठे हैं ना, आराम से बैठे हैं, लाइट लगी है, टेबल इज गुड, वी हैव फूड इन आवर, यू नो, लाइक इन आवर फ्रिज, राइट? आई कैन बाय थिंग्स फॉर माई सन, आई कैन पे स्कूल फीस फॉर माई सन, राइट? सो है ना, कर लेंगे यार.
सो फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द ऑडियंस, व्हाइल यू नो टेक अ सिगरेट, सो आई विल जस्ट गो ओवर देम, यू नो, नॉट एवरीबॉडी मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ व्हाट दैट
रिक्वायर्स
ऑफ पर से.
प्लीज डू.
या सो we initially Operation Blue Freedom was launched as a adaptive scuba diving program where we training people with disabilities, and we were wanting to institutionalize scuba diving as a rehabilitation for them. So you conceptualize the triple world record. So basically we are creating three world records by people with disabilities in all three elements of land, sea and air, in adaptive scuba diving, adaptive skydiving and adaptive mountaineering. So the world record in water will be for the largest team of people with disabilities scuba diving simultaneously in the open seas and conducting the largest, world's largest scuba based rehabilitation and skilling program. So that is the world record for in the element of water. In the element of air, it will be the largest team of people with disabilities skydiving in a single event, you know, independently. So that is the air world record. This is planned in Dubai, and the water world record is planned in Maldives, and the last world record, that is the land world record, is something very, very exciting in the sense that it will be the largest team of people with disabilities scaling the world's highest battlefield, that is Siachen Glacier. So we'll be training them in adaptive mountaineering. We have instructors from,
if we get the government permission.
Yeah, subject to
koi na koi pahar to chadh jayenge aur record bana denge. And it's not about the record, alright. At the end of the day, this world record thing is for some very logical reasons. But otherwise, climb any mountain, yeah, we'll climb a very, very difficult mountain, it'll be very, very high mountain, and buddy, a lot of people in this world will look at that mountain and will not want to climb it, right? We'll climb that fucking mountain, right? So it's not about the world record, but we're showing something, yeah. So it's just like easy to crunch it down to world record, you know,
yeah,
like that.
Yeah. So that is the land world record, where it will be the largest team of people with disabilities scaling, supposedly now, Siachen Glacier, subject to a lot of other considerations which are beyond our control. And hats of God are obviously there. Yeah.
The universe doesn't want it, it's not good.
Yeah. So, there are a lot of misconceptions, you know, what is CLAW Global all about, you know. So, sometimes people think that we are a company that is, you know, some kind of a special forces guys getting together and just giving scuba training and running an adventure sports company, or you know, training people in mountaineering and things like that. So the common misconceptions, or there is lack of clarity on what CLAW Global is. right? If you could explain that a little as to what Clock Global is, or for that matter, what Operation Blue Freedom
most
is.
Most difficult thing to do, to explain what Clock Global is. Clock Global is an expression of life itself. Clock Global is about the protection and the expansion of the experience of freedom, right? It is based on certain logical factors of how to achieve that level of life and living and freedom for everyone. In life, to experience certain things, you have to have certain skills to be able to experience that. You jump out of an aircraft, you know, with a parachute you don't know how to open, you will die, right? So if you want to experience skydiving, you need to know how to operate a parachute, and you need to, you know, you need to have certain skills. You need to be to learn those skills to be able to do something. So we've got certain bunch of skills. In the special forces, we learn certain skills. Mindset is one thing, right? But there are certain real life skills that you need to be having with you to be able to have a very good life experience, a secure life experience, and like an open life experience, to be able to do things, you know, safely. So you need to have skills. So there are certain skills which I felt that they're like life skills, right? Ye basic cheez to har insaan ko aana chahiye. Main apne bete ko sikha raha hu, right? My own son, I am teaching those things. People should know three basic things first. Firstly, they should know how to protect themselves and their loved ones, right? They should know martial arts, self-defense, ye wo, ye sab aana chahiye, right? So second thing is, people should know how to save other people, themselves and other people, right? Protect themselves and other people, save themselves and other people. For example, you know, there are so many people who die of heart attacks, yeah? About 80% of people who experience heart attacks don't reach the hospital. Because वो फिर है ना एम्बुलेंस आएगी, अगर आई तो आ गई तो वो ट्रैफिक में कोई साइड देगा नहीं देगा पता नहीं, कोई जाम हो जाएगा, कुछ हो जाएगा, एम्बुलेंस को शायद ना जाने दें, कुछ हो जाएगा, राइट? और जब तक वो आएंगे, यू नो, ये हार्ट अटैक हो रहा है भाई, यू नो, योर हार्ट इज इन दैट कंडीशन, यू नो, समथिंग इज गॉट ब्लॉक्ड और व्हाटएवर इज हैपेंड एंड यू आर इन दैट कंडीशन एंड बाय द टाइम द एम्बुलेंस विल कम, यू 80 people die, they don't reach the hospital. So if for example, if my father were here, right, agar mere father yahan hote aur unko heart attack ho raha hota to unko bas CPR ki zarurat thi. Out of the 100 people who die, if that got, you know, 70 of them would have survived, it got CPR then and there, CPR would have saved them. Just CPR is just such a simple thing to do, right? And so we in the special forces go into areas where hamare sath doctor nahi chal raha hai. पूरी पलटन में एक ही डॉक्टर होता है, राइट? तो भाई हम लोग है ना, वो डॉक्टर कहाँ कहाँ जाएगा, हम तो सब निकले हुए हैं, राइट? तो एंड हम वी आर हंटिंग एंड बड़ी ऑपरेशन इज ऑन, कॉन्टैक्ट है, गोलियां चल रही हैं, किसी को भी लग सकती है, किसी को भी लग सकती है, डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर लक लेवल ऑफ प्लानिंग एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन डेस्टिनी, राइट? तो जब किसी को गोली लग जाती है तो क्या वो मर जाएगा? वो मतलब अगर तेरे को गोली लग गई तो क्या मैं तेरे को मरने दूंगा? नहीं यार, यू नो, आई विल डू समथिंग. नाउ आई वांट टू डू समथिंग, आई शुड हैव द स्किल्स टू बी एबल टू डू दैट. आई शुड नो हाउ टू, वेयर इज द बुलेट विच आई शुड बी एबल टू असेस यू डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर एनर्जी इंजरी. आई शुड बी एबल टू सी कि ओके यार, इसका ये अंदर से फट गया होगा, इसका ये बॉडी के अंदर ये डैमेज हुआ है, यू नो, वाइटल ऑर्गन लगा है नहीं लगा है, राइट? एंड क्या बोलते हैं, देन आई शुड बी एबल टू एड्रेस दैट. I may not be a heart surgeon, but buddy, I can give a CPR. I could have saved my father, right? Such a thing. इतना सा एक छोटी सी चीज आती तो मैं अपने father की जान बचा लेता, right? So it's and so this thing everybody should know. So advanced medical skills, first response skills should be a basic skill which everybody should know. It's a life skill. पांचवी क्लास से बच्चे को सिखा देना शुरू कर देना चाहिए, right? तो इट सेव यू सो मेनी हॉस्पिटल बिल्स ऑल्सो, राइट? सो ये हो गया. सो प्रोटेक्टिंग योर सेल्फ, प्रोटेक्टिंग योर लव्ड वंस, यू नो, एंड देन सेविंग योर सेल्फ, सेविंग योर लव्ड वंस. मैंने शायद यार अपनी लाइफ में 3 रोड एक्सीडेंट में मैंने CPR दिया है. आई हैव ब्रॉट अ मैन बैक ऑन द बैक सीट ऑफ माई कार, ही हैड गॉट हिट एंड मतलब तो उसका यार उसकी तो मैंने उसको देख के ही लगा था ये तो गया. सो आई वॉज लाइक, इट्स जस्ट अ लाइव एग्जाम्पल, राइट? एंड I was with my course mate and I had gone to the Indian Military Academy for some reason, and I was with my course mate. I was a major that time, and I was coming outside the gate of the Indian Military Academy, and I saw bheed, the left side wale road mein bheed. So we just stopped and said, "Yaar, accident ho rakha hai. Truck ruki hui thi thodi dur, aur fir you know, aise karke, and bheed thi." So I stopped and I told my coach, "Rukna hai, dekhte hain karke." And I just saw, and there was this guy lying on the road, and he had been lying there for the last, you know, like 10 minutes. Kisi ne usko haath nahi lagaya tha. वो पड़ा हुआ था रोड के ऊपर और उसके उसने वॉकमैन लगा था, हेलमेट उसने पहन नहीं रखी थी, बाइक उसकी बड़ी 100 मीटर आगे पड़ी थी, पता नहीं कितनी स्पीड में था वो बंदा. एंड ही हैड हिट अगेंस्ट दैट ट्रक एंड हिज ईयरफोन्स, ही हैड बीन लिसनिंग टू म्यूजिक, राइट, हिज ईयरफोन्स वर आउट ऑफ हिज ईयर्स एंड ही वॉज लाइंग ऑन द ग्राउंड एंड हिज राइट लेग वॉज ट्विस्टेड वंस ट्वाइस थ्राइस, तीन बार घूम गया था ऐसे करके पूरा टांग. And his right arm was again twisted like that. Well, it was in pieces. Matlab, the bone inside it must have been in pieces. His body was in shock. Right? Brain had more or less shut down. He was not conscious. But like in a sense, he was not aware. But he was breathing. मैंने यही देखा कि सांस ले रहा है नहीं ले रहा है. सांस ले रहा था. जिंदा था. And people were just looking, and you know, somebody had their mobile phones out or what not. So I just picked him up, told my coachmate, open the car door, पीछे उसको back seat में लिटाया, and just moved from there, asked the people, I didn't know where the hospital was, right? So I asked people there, hospital कहाँ है? बोला वो उधर है, उधर 10 किलोमीटर दूर. So I said, चलो let's fucking drive, you know. So we were driving and he was in the back seat and I was like co-driver and I was looking like this and I saw he stopped breathing, he's dead, right? So I told my coachman, you keep driving. I got on, piche mod gaya, I got on the seat and he was on, I pushed him on his back and I gave him CPR. Right? And he was dead. And karke he came back like that. And I saw that. And okay, drive. Karke, he died a second time. Right? I gave him fucking CPR second time. He came back alive again, just like that, taking a huge breath in. Right? एंड बिल्कुल लग रहा था ट्रैफिक है, ये वो आई स्टॉप आई आस्क सम ऑफ द कॉप्स, यार कि यार बंदा मर रहा है, थोड़ा ट्रैफिक करा दो. सो आई वाज सीइंग कि नहीं यार, रिएक्शन ही नहीं आ रहा है, पीपल डोंट गिव अ शिट यार, आई डोंट नो व्हाई, राइट? आई मीन दैट कुड हैपन टू यू, इट कुड हैपन टू योर फादर, इट कुड बी योर सन, इट कुड बी योर वाइफ, इट कुड बी योर हूएवर, यू नो, रिलेटेड टू यू, हू यू लव वेरी वेरी मच, लाइंग देयर ऑन दैट रोड एंड नोबडी फकिंग हेल्पिंग, राइट? आइदर बिकॉज दे आर अफ्रेड टू, or they don't know what to do, just simply simple as that, they don't know what to do, right? So and you know, unfortunately so he died a third time. By the time we reached the like hospital and I gave him a third CPR, he wasn't coming back. So I had to decide what to do, you know, and take him. So I just lifted him up and took him into the emergency room and put him on the this thing and called the doctor, isko bachao, right? He's abhi mara hai, abhi bas badi 2 minute pehle ye saans le raha tha. So doc looked at him, ye to mar gaya, he's dead, right? Jo bhi hai, whatever, you know, then that guy actually didn't make it, right? But then there were other people who have made it. So that's why, so this skill you should have, yeah, it should be compulsory. And then what else? So protect yourself, save other people, and have the skills to enjoy your life. What are the skills to? All terrain survival, right? You should be able to go into the mountains. You should be able to take your loved ones, and you should be able to go through bare naked terrain. You should be able to travel across hundreds of kilometers of very raw, rugged terrain and survive it. You should have those skills. Right, you should be able to survive and enjoy the forest, jungles, right? You should be able to survive in the oceans, in the seas. Because if you can't, you will not be able to experience it, right? So you must have the skills to be able to survive there so you can experience it and enjoy it, right? So these are, so when a human being has these three skills, just these three skills, usko angrezi bolni aati hai, nahi aati hai, par agar usko ye teen skill aate hain, he is fucking Superman. Right, he's good man, Superman, good for mankind, great human being, and that guy will be so confident about himself. At the end of the day, everybody has brains. IQ लेवल उतना ही है, 10% 11% के बीच में पीपल आर ऑपरेटिंग देयर ब्रेन्स, राइट? वी ऑपरेट आवर ब्रेन्स बिटवीन दैट IQ लेवल. एवरीबॉडी हैज द सेम फ्रिकिंग IQ लेवल यार. हाउ मेनी ऑफ अस आर डूइंग फकिंग कैलकुलस, राइट? सो इन दैट स्पेक्ट्रम, इफ देयर, इफ यू थ्रो इन कॉन्फिडेंस, राइट, इफ यू थ्रो इन कॉन्फिडेंस कि नहीं यार मैं कर सकता हूं, कॉन्फिडेंस नॉट बेस्ड ऑन स्टुपिडिटी, कॉन्फिडेंस बेस्ड ऑन स्किल्स, रियल लाइफ स्किल्स. आई कैन क्लाइम दिस माउंटेन, I know I can do this, right? So, if you have these skills, you will be confident. And if you will be confident, you will be a good man. Because people actually do, you know, destructive things often because of lack of confidence. So, confidence aa jayega. And, you know, you should have these skills, and they should be compulsory for everyone. So I felt that, you know, we can share these skills. So PLAW Global is a lot about sharing the mindset of special forces, all the skill sets that we have. Like, I'm not going to teach you how to take a weapon and kill somebody. No, that you don't need to know, right? But you need to know how to protect yourself. You need to know how to save other people. You need to know how to enjoy your environment. These things, we have got skills at a very, very specialized level, with about 15 to 20 years of experience doing that at an extreme level, right? Training backed by 15, 20 years of experience, operating together in an extreme level of environment. So we know what we are doing, right? So PLAW Global is about picking up the best of the best mindset of
selecting skills and transferring it.
Yes, and then sharing it with everyone. Yeah. So that's one part of PLAW Global. And yeah, so that's one part of PLAW Global, and
in some ways Operation Blue Freedom is one of the first manifestations of it.
Yes, so if somebody actually looks at Operation Blue Freedom and analyzes it, he will find both these skills over there.
Yeah.
So that's what it is. This is the first expression of ourselves. This is the first step. Operation Blue Freedom Triple World Records is the first step of PLAW Global into the big, big wide world. So like that.
That in itself explains the future roadmap in the
sense
that what after the Operation Blue Freedom Triple World Records. So Triple World Records, not a one-off instance where you come and do some jazzy stuff and go away. It's a well thought out, logically connected event which has deeply linked future roadmap ahead. So if you can briefly go over what you intend doing going forward.
So, okay, I'll tell you what we are doing, and then maybe, you know, if we have time, we'll talk about why we are doing it, right? So what we are doing specifically is we are creating, this is like this triple world records apne aap to nahi hoga ki main jaunga aur main 50 logon ko kara dunga to nahi hoga. I don't have this thing, but what I have is a heart, and this heart is shared by a lot of people, right? This heart, this ability, this special mindset. So I realized this thing. I realized, pehle main sochta tha yaar ki yahi hai, but you know, special forces mein hi logon ka waisa hota hai. But when I came outside and I met, you know, people on the city street, right? I was very cut off from this world. Almost about 9.5-10 years I have spent outside this reality. I have lived in forests and mountains, right? And lived in a way where I didn't know if I'll be alive tomorrow, if I'll see the morning sun. I didn't know that, right? Constantly living there in the moment in that environment. So this is a very different environment. But then I met people from Civi Street here, and I found that generally people are good there. Generally people are good from heart. Everybody has a heart, right? People have insecurities just like me. Everybody else has them. And everybody else wants to try and work around their insecurities and experience some level of freedom, of expression, of karma, right? And amongst these people, there are people who have expanded consciousness, and they have a lot of confidence, and they believe that they can do a lot of things, and they are very, very skilled. They are very, very focused in what their task is. I mean, like, you look at him, right? Look at Meen Bahadur. All of these people are very, very creative in their skill set. They're very, very focused. They don't need anything to be able to do what they do, right? They can do it. So if people like that, so there are special people everywhere, right? It's not only special forces, mein special log hain. It's a certain task, we're good at what we do, right? And there are people who are good at what they do everywhere. And Operation Blue Freedom is the culmination of a lot of skills. Lot of very, very specialized people with a lot of heart, all of them coming together and achieving something of that level. Something that has never been created before. Something that the world will know. Right? Ki yaar ki ye hai, ye bhi ek jeene ka tarika hai yaar. So, kya kehte hain? So anyway, so what are we going to do? So it's of that level and I was quite fed up of, you know. So I'll tell you what we are doing first. So as soon as Operation Blue Freedom, actually when the first world record onwards will be going down, will be happening, we already actually started making all the tie-ups and all. We want to set up Operation Blue Freedom full spectrum rehabilitation facilities, right? Across the globe, you know, North America, we want to set it up in, you know, starting from home. You know, we want to set it up in Lakshadweep, India. We are already talking to ISIC, Indian Spinal Injury Center. We are talking to them and we have proposed our concept. And we told them, like, I don't know about your money also. So money aayega na yaar, Operation Blue Freedom, money aayega. You know, I'll just tell you, you know, it's like this, yaar, if a sponsor's board is not there, you know, if like sometimes people who relate to what we are doing, they would, you know, I mean, what's the point of like advertising, for example? Right, so you have a certain celebrity that you promote. Everybody's a human being, everybody's good, great, but it's like I saw this ad, you know, I saw this ad where Salman Khan was standing on top of a mountain and he was wearing a wingsuit and he was supposed to have jumped off that mountain with that wingsuit and reached down somewhere, or sorry, before jumping off he drank some drink. Mountain Dew. Dar ke aage jeet hai. Right, and I saw that ad. I said, bullshit. That guy doesn't know how to wingsuit. And this is a lie. Right? And companies are spending freaking crores of rupees in telling that stupid lie. Right? Arey yaar, you see what we are doing. And this is what, you know, like, yeah, people need inspiration. People want to be inspired to live their lives completely. Right? People look at each other and learn from each other. They look at this and maybe they inculcate something. So when they put the, you know, when they take part, genuinely, if you want to spend your money in something that is going to give value to everyone and draw value for your own brand, right? You put your money here, yeah. So we are planning to generate a lot of financial resources from this, so that we can open up our operation. That's going to be cutting edge stuff. And that's going to be our first step. We plan to go into robotics. We plan to do a lot of things, right? All of that requires money. So I want to sort out this money business first, right? Supposedly, to do something, you need to have money, right? So we'll create the bloody money, yaar. I'll create the bloody money. I'll create that money to do what I want to do, right? And if it is something that is good, the universe will support it. People will walk with me and we'll fucking do that. And we will make a lot of lives a better experience. Right, including my own. Thank you very much. Always help others by helping. Plan to generate a lot of, so not only financial resources, when Operation Blue Freedom, like I said, the world has to be involved for this to happen. Right? People have to be involved, people have to share their talents, people have to share their heart, people have to share their belief. And this will happen. Right? It is happening in any case. And there are people like that in the world and they're already sharing it. It will happen. Right? So when it happens, we will. To make this happen, we are making those kind of connections with people across the world, right? People who want to make a change, who want to make a life experience better for everyone and for all life around us, right? Animals, trees, and ourselves, right? The fish in the sea, you know, stuff like that. So everybody, so we are not only going to be generating a lot of financial resources to be able to execute what we have planned to do, to build these world-class cutting-edge facilities where, you know, a man will walk in or come in, like a person who's, let's just say a person who's had a road accident, right, and he's got paralyzed waist down and he's on a wheelchair and he's shocked with life. Till about, you know, till a day back, that guy was playing football in the field, and or maybe I was having a fight in the school, right? And suddenly there's a road accident which has happened and he can't move, right? Now it's in his whole perception of life has been shattered, right? So that person, you know, and that thing can happen to any of us anytime. So there's a very, you know, there's a statistics that people don't really like know. I mean, I don't know if they know it or not, but it's what I saw. Firstly, there's this 1.8 billion people with disabilities across the world, right? And let's just say there are about 100 people with disabilities in our world, right? There are 100 people who have disabilities in our world, right? Now those, out of those 100 people, only 20 are those people who have got their disability at birth. Rest 80 have got, you know, have acquired disability at some point of time in their life. So it can happen to anyone. And all of us are going to grow old as well, right? So we'll need it at some point or other in life to live a better life. So we want to set up that facility. When somebody walks in, comes into our facility and he comes into our folds, right? He will be nurtured. He'll be nurtured over a period of about a year, right? He can forget about his responsibilities of ki paisa kahan se aayega, ye kaise hoga, wo kaise hoga, are hum karenge, right? Hum karenge. और अंदर लेके आएंगे और जब वो एक साल बाद या डेढ़ साल बाद जब हमारे यहाँ से दरवाजे से बाहर जाएगा, राइट, ही विल बी स्किल्ड, ही विल बी बड़ी, ही वुड हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद द वर्ल्ड. वी आर प्लानिंग टू हैव जॉइंट स्किल ट्रेनिंग, यू नो, सेशंस वेयर पीपल, यू नो, एबल बॉडीड पीपल और नॉन डिसेबल्ड पीपल और व्हाटएवर, यू नो, हु कम इन एंड दे जॉइंटली ट्रेन विद पीपल हु हैव गॉट इंजर्ड इन लाइफ, you know, or born with a certain kind of disability, and they learn skills together. You have to bring disability out of the closet, right? So how many people with wheelchairs have you, like, you though we have seen a lot, we have walked this journey, but, you know, just example, for example, let's ask, you know, Arman,
difficult to,
how many people with wheelchairs have you seen in your life?
Not many, maybe 10,
maybe 10, right? And I mean, the figures are
hard to visualize.
Yeah, because they don't come out. They don't come out because the environment is hostile. I mean, you can't do susu properly in a hygienic manner, so forget about everything else, yeah. Right? So they don't come out. So you don't get to see them. So you have to create an infrastructure. You have to create an environment where they can come out. We're all human beings. We're all one. And it can, this life is, you know, anything but predictable. So, and everything, there's only one constant, and that constant is change. So if you are like this right now, you know, if you could be like something else, you know, you may lose your life or limb the next minute, the next time, you know, whatever. So we will create these facilities, and they come in and they get all these skills, and they are given a, you know, they're brought in and they're cushioned and taught and skilled and rehabilitated and through scuba diving. Is one of the things that we're majorly looking at. So scuba diving is an immense amount of healing power on the body, right? I'm not going to get into the physics or the chemistry or whatever of that, but it is so. And you can just Google it and you'll see, right? And if we are looking at scuba diving not only through recreation, he is, you know, it is recreation, yes, but it is a meditative experience. It's spiritually healing. Right? It is also physically healing, right? It is also emotionally healing, right? You may be like, you know, you may have 10 court cases or, you know, going on land, but if you're underwater and you're scuba diving for an hour, you won't remember it, yeah. Right? So you're kind of free and it's meditative. So all these, it's a very healing environment. And in this healing environment, if a person who has suffered a disability can heal and learn how to make money while staying in this healing environment, that's fantastic. It's logical. It should be so, yeah. Right? Maybe all 100 people with, you know, spinal cord injuries may not be able to do it, right? But at least 30 to kar lenge, 40 to kar lenge, to utna to karein pehle. Let's take this step, generate more resources, invest money into researching, into robotics, into, you know, you are building exoskeletons for making super soldiers, right? For combat, for destruction, you are investing so much of money into that. Why don't you? I mean, we could invest a lot of money into doing this, where we develop high-end prosthetics, high-end robotic, you know, prosthetics, exoskeletons, stuff like that, and really high-end. We invest into that. We get talent like that from, you know, super talent like that from across the world, very, very creative people, and get them together, get that talent together, facilitate them, create this stuff, which in any case, you know, all of us are going to use at some point or the other in life. So we have a lot of plans, and we are, through this one thing, we are showing, we are creating, we are changing the bloody perception, we are shattering the perception. The biggest thing that I detest, and maybe something that I learned from my father, is this aversion to pity. Right? I have an aversion to pity. It doesn't make sense, yeah, to like feel pity, either for yourself or for anyone else. Right? You have, you know, yeah, so I'm talking about power here. I'm not talking about charity. And this is what I experienced also. Wherever I was going, I was asking for something. Koi mere ko swimming pool de do, koi mujhe kuch, you know, scuba equipment de do, mujhe koi kuch de do, koi kuch de do. Right? Some people used to understand, some people would not understand. And I got fed up at a certain point of trying to explain to people that, you know, we all need this, we should be doing this. Right? And you want to make a profit out of it, I'll tell you how. You have to monetize the damn market. It's a market. Right? You have to look at it like that. Ki, yeah, there are hardly any products or services for people with disabilities, in spite of them being 1.8 billion strong in the world. Right? There are hardly any products and services. Why is it so? Because of people don't have not figured out where do you get money into this. As of now, money is coming into this, is channelized into this particular market through charity. I'm saying balls to charity. Wo to hai, achhi baat hai yaar, you must donate, you feel good, it's nice, you must do that. Right? But it should not be dependent. My life cannot be dependent on another man's charity. Yeah? My life should be dependent on my bloody ability of what I can create and what I can do for myself and for the people I love around me. Right? Yeah. Freedom. So we will create that value, we'll give those skills. So like that.
Some way that explains the why also.
Yeah.
I was just thinking, you know, to give people a sneak peek into your
my box of treasures, my table of treasures.
Personal life per se, you know, there's a lot of curiosity around how Special Forces soldier lives his life.
Special Forces soldier does not live his life like this. Retired Special Forces soldiers live like this.
Yeah. So if you go over your prized possessions.
Yeah. All of these. So मैंने फौज से ना मैं ज़्यादा कुछ लेके नहीं आया वापस. मैंने अपनी यूनिफॉर्म, बेल्ट, बूट, जूते वूते जो यूजेबल चीज़ें थी मैंने अपने जूनियर्स को दे दी, which they could use in ops, right? I had some good things, very efficient for operations. I gave it to them. And it felt very good. So I didn't actually फौज में भी मेरे पास ज़्यादा positions नहीं थे, but ये कुछ चीज़ें थी जो मैंने रखी हैं, right? And like this is a start from here. Or okay, so this is the parachute regiment. This is the para brigade. I served here, and I was a peace posting. And I was in peace and I was in a staff appointment. And I was given this memento there. It marks the memory of that time. Right? This is a beer mug. It's nine para ka beer mug hai. And that's nine, when I was in nine. And I have another one of this actually. So, but anyway, so this is nine, and this is where I lived most of my journey, right? And that is
some ways made you what you are.
That is 11 para special forces. That battalion has such a fantastic story behind it of how it was formed, right? So the rogues, ruffians, and villains of special forces were all collected under this one roof. It was like coming home.
Yeah.
And I had like, it was so amazing, you know, coming back into the, going to this environment where everybody was like, yeah, khatarnak super soldiers outside, like pure destruction on 2 feet, right? And home, we were all chilling. It was so lovely people, beautiful human beings, lovely people, right?
many people don't know a lot of Indian mythology. You know, people know a lot of Greek mythologies. You can just come close to this. So just explain this. It's called as the Shatrujit. You know, people would know Pegasus, but many people don't know what a Shatrujit is. You know, it's the Indian equivalent of it. So many of these people know Greek mythology and all of that, but people should know that there are a lot of such icons in Indian mythology as well. So there are a lot of symbolisms associated. People are very aware of what a Balidan is and how it looks. You know, it's wings in a blood red color background and a dagger. So this is also one of the symbols associated with the parachute regiment, that is the Pegasus equivalent in India, that is the Shatruji. Half human, half angel, half horse, half human, angel kind of a person who is operating his bow and arrow. That is that. So that was a sneak peek into Major Jacob's personal life.
There's more. I'll show you here. So, so this, of course, I made this. I thought it was a space that I could use for people could sit and chill, right? So that, and I like a reading corner, and those big cushions, those I stole from my ex-wife, and like some, those are all my memories, right? Some beautiful thing, and that is like Major Ambali's like stuff lying there. He uses it like a shelf also. And mucks up my home.
What about those pine cones?
So those pine cones. So all something, these are all beautiful, you know, parts of me. Beautiful, like what I treasure. You know, somebody gave me something I value it a lot. It's love, right? So the cones are basically a poor man's expression of love.
<It's like that. laughs>
So it's like this. So when I was operating in the mountains and all, though we used to take harbor, right?
Yeah.
So in harbor, in the day when you're in the forest, and they're all high altitude, the pine trees. So there used to be these fallen pine roses, you know, on the this thing, and they're like
floor,
they look like roses, you know, like beautiful. And I used to carry these. I used to select some cones and put them in my rucksack and say, whenever kabhi main kabhi chutti jaunga agar kabhi. So like, you know, I was a bachelor at that time, and you know, so I used to give it to girls I used to like. So like that. Yeah. There are things that, you know, which are treasures in life. So I like to keep my treasures close to me, the beautiful things of my life, and I see them, that there's something, there's an energy to it, and they have beautiful memories to them, right? So these are some of the things that, you know, that I surround myself with. And there's Shadow, of course. She's like the thing. Shadow is me, and I am her. She's like more like I am her. And so is Shadow, and Shadow is no more. She was my shadow for 12 years. We were in love with each other. And if there's, you know, like love, pure love, there's love. And kya bolte hain, a lot of things about her, but as a student, she was loved to bits, and she loved to bits back. Like that, she was really something. All those people who have met her, you know, she was, there's something very, very special about her. All animals, all human beings are special in their own way, and she was special in her own way. She was very, very special. And she actually, there was a point of time in my life where I was like, you can say I was at the bottom of the well, and she was the reason why I came back to life, decided to choose to experience life rather than not to experience it. You know, like, she was the reason why I said, okay, yeah, I mean, she needs to go for a walk. She needs to eat well. So,
in some ways, it was truly your shadow, metaphorically.
Yeah, she held my. This particular mug was gifted to by somebody whom I love a lot and loves me. Who I love and who loves me, right? And this this my ashtray. So for some reason it became the ashtray. It was an ashtray, very, you know, in a way everything that I do is for a reason. And this is, like I said, this is a coffee mug from the unit which destiny chose for me, you know, finally, from where I retired and I lived my last 2 years in Levin by myself. And it's got the Balidan on this side and it's like the Balidan there, right? And this is us hunting. This is a photograph of us hunting and you know, in operations. And it's written, you know, brothers, you know. And it's a little cliche, but it's like very meaningful. We, brothers don't always have the same mother, right? That's how we operate. Hamari maa ek nahi hogi, par hum bhai hain, right? We are brothers. So that's there, and you know, it's like love for me. So out of love, I made it my ashtray. It's always there near me, right?
Connected to your identity, how you look at yourself.
Yeah, probably. And that is deeper than I can understand. This is a harmonica which I bought for my beautiful son, Kevin. I bought it for him, and I always wanted to learn. My father used to play the harmonica and used to have a lot of fun with it. And then I saw that my son has an inclination towards music, thankfully. Because the human beings should, you know, how to create music. He should know, you know, make his own music. So like that. And when children at a young age, if they are exposed to any musical instrument, and you know, this is like convenient as well. You just carry it in your pocket, like a guitar, it's big. And I thought he'd like, you know, to play with it, and he'll learn how to use it, and it'll be a beautiful thing that I could, you know, like give an experience to my son. So I bought it for him. So this is that
as well.
Me? No, I don't play.
Think about music, you said. So
I'm a wannabe player. But my son is enjoying it, and he's this thing. And there are other things there. Hey, I don't know if you can just like point in that direction. I told you about this. These are all little things that, which are very meaningful parts of my life. I've met a lot of lovely people in my life, lovely human beings in my life, you know. And we shared love, right? We shared love, and little pieces of love shared, you know, make us what we are. That's the beauty of our life, love.
Symbolism of the owl. So I see a lot of owl art pieces in the house. I've counted 9 so far.
I don't know. For some reason, I like owls. I don't know why as yet. But one definite reason is they are very, very cute. Owls are like amazing. They're intelligent, and they've got this big head, you know, and big eyes, and they can like rotate their head like that. So you know, it's really, and they're very, yeah, it's like they, you can interact with them, you know. So I like owls a lot, and there's something very, and they operate at night, you know.
Yeah.
So I resonate with that. I do a lot. I've done most of my life, actually, my work that I've done at night when I was in special forces. I was operating at night, and when I was training in special forces, I was training at night. And now most of our work, if you see, when the world sleeps, we do our work, and when the world wakes up, you know, we are ready to meet them, and you know, like that. So like that.
So yeah, with that we'll wrap up. I mean, it's quite a insightful session as always. So we'll try and do more of this. I know there's a lot of demand for people to see more of Major Jacob often and share his insights. So this is a journey that all of us are walking. This is a journey that we would like you also to walk with us. You know, so this is one way where we would like to connect with you.
Don't follow me. Walk with me, come with me, we'll go and do something fucking amazing.
Yeah. So it's a journey that is
together.
It's a collective experience, like, you know, it's freedom for all of us. So that's why we want to, you know, take you also along, and we'll let us all move together, you know. So we'll try and do more of this. So that is for today. So you can reach out to us and tell us what you would like to know more. Thank you.
Thank you guys. Thanks. Thanks, Ambi.
Yeah.